Hey YouTube, Kpaceguy here. 2014 update of my bedroom home theater system. So, right here in front of my door is just memories of basketball. I used to play basketball when I was a little bit younger. It used to be good before I got to college and I stopped playing. But that's what's on my door. And if you open the door and go into my room. Now, forgive me for this giant window in the back, it has to focus. So, let's walk through. So, this is going to be a tour of my home theater system. Now, I don't know if you guys can really see it, but it's a 7.1 surround sound system, right? Let's start with the receiver, the powerhouse, the boss of it all. So, this is one upgrade that I've gotten since the last time I made a video. This is the Pioneer SC-1222. Much, much better than my last one. I used to have the Pioneer 821K. I used to have that one. And I upgraded this maybe 6 months ago. Had to get better sound. Had to get better sound. So that's one of the things that I upgrade. I still have my big O F12, my Big America F12 powered subwoofer, 12-inch subwoofer. I have new speakers. I now have, these are called Fluence. I don't know if you see the name. Let me go to the other speaker. Here you go. These are called Fluence. Fluence is a very, very good brand of speaker. It's not commonly known, but it's been around for a while. But they sound phenomenal for the price. I got a 5.1 speaker set up for $4.99. I was like, okay, $4.99 for 5 speakers. That can't be that good. But these things are actually really nice. I don't use the whole 5.1. I just use the fronts. And I have the rears, but right now the rears don't fit into this room. But the Fluences are a new addition to the room. Now, I also didn't show you guys the sound panels that I have across the walls. I have, I think, let's see, 12 panels on the wall. 12 panels on the wall. And these things help phenomenally. If you guys are into any kind of music in a bedroom or any kind of room actually, and you're playing drums or you're playing music or it's a home theater or it's anything that is musical, you're gonna wanna get sound panels. And these are just $50 for six. $50 for six off of Amazon. And they do justice. They do just what I need them to do for a bedroom. They stop echoes. They keep reflection off and the sound. And it helps keep the sound from bouncing across the walls. When I say bouncing across the walls, I mean you don't just hear the sound once. It bounces, it reflects, it ricochets. And you don't want that when you're doing anything musical because it messes up the sound that you get. It doesn't reproduce the sound as clean as it could. So I'm a huge musical head. I love sound. So everything has to sound perfect or I'm going to continue to tweak it until it does. So on the sound panels, I have my headphones, my Apple headphones. I have headphones on this one. I have headphones on this one. Over here, I have headphones on these and headphones on those. And most of these headphones don't work. They've all broken in one ear or the other. The right headphone doesn't work or the left, whatever. So sound panels are also a new addition. I still have my Polk Audio center channel. I'm not sure what model this is. It's a really weird name. It's in the CS family, older, but it's very, very good, and I'm probably never going to get a new one. This is what I needed to do. My room's very, very small, but I have a lot of big sound, because I don't really care if my room's small. I still want that big sound, you know? So I can always just turn it down. So still have that. Still have my Sony SF towers. They're really nice. They're being used as rears, as my surround left and right, my Sony's. I took off the branding name on there because I like to have all my brands not look like they're different, even though they are. I like them all to be uniform, so I took off the branding except for the Fluences down there. I kept those the same. In the back, I have these little cube speakers just for the surround backs. They do what they need to do. I can't really have anything big back here because this is where the bed sits and this is the door on both sides. There's a door. So I can't really have anything big. But I do have some bookshelf speakers that I was using before I put the bed in. new addition as well is my futon. Now, my futon is very, very nice. I took the bed out for a while and just had a futon to kind of give it that man cave feeling, that lounge feeling, not a bedroom feeling. But I ended up putting the bed back in here because, you know, after a while, futons are just not what you want to sleep on. But the futon's actually very, very comfortable. I did sleep on this for about 3 months before I put the bed back in. But that's my bed for all the girls who want to see what the bed looks like. You can't be in it, though. I'm sorry. But this is what it looks like. I'm actually going to get new bed sheets this week. They're going to be a different color. You guys are never going to see them because I'm not going to post another video just specifically for the bed. But this is what it looks like now. It's very, very comfortable. The mattress is very, very nice. I'm big on making my bed when I get up in the morning. I get up, I make the bed. I don't leave the room because a messy bed is a messy room. I don't like messy rooms. So the futon is the new addition. I love it. This is where I just sit down to play my video games. Now, speaking of video games, I have a new addition as well when it comes to systems. The Xbox One is new to the family. Oops, I just clicked something. I love my Xbox One when it wants to listen to me. I'm just playing. If I can just back out of what I just pushed on the Xbox One, I can show you the home screen. For those who do not have an Xbox One, get an Xbox One. For those who have a PS4, you should have got an Xbox One. Now, I like both systems. I used to have a PlayStation 1, PlayStation 2, and I play PlayStation 3, but I've always been an Xbox guy since the big block Xbox, the big black one. I always played that one. And then the 360 came out, I played that, and then they made new versions of the 360, and now the Xbox One. I love the Xbox One. I'm just an Xbox fan. I love what you can do on Xbox, not just gaming, it's apps, it's music, it's yada, yada, yada. You can have apps to go with your Xbox. It's just amazing. I love the Kinect and all that other stuff. So, Xbox One is the way to go. It's also cheaper and stuff. If you want to learn more about Xbox One, I have one video of it, of an unboxing, but it's kind of bad. But I do know lots about it. So if you guys have any questions or you want to know if it's worth it or not, I can definitely tell you. But yes, I have the Xbox One as a new addition to the family. And I'm going to sadly sell my Xbox 360 eventually. I don't use it. It just sits here. I sold all my games except one. And yeah, it's time to just go ahead and say goodbye to that generation and hello to the new. I only had 3 games on Xbox One. I have Call of Duty Ghosts, which I play quite frequently. If you guys want to add me, my name is Kyle Pace with capital K-L in the Kyle and capital P-C in the Pace. So you can add me if you want to. I am always on. I am always adding people. There's my name right there in the corner for those who don't know what I said. Kyle Pace, capital Y, capital K, capital L, capital P, capital C. I'm going to change my name soon, but I'm sure I'll tell you guys what it is. So yes, Xbox One. I play Ghost. I have Need for Speed, I think it's Rivals. I have Need for Speed Rivals, if you guys want to play me in that. And I also just got today in the mail, just got Thief for Xbox One. That is going to be a great game. I cannot wait to play it. So those are my new additions to the room. Beanbag chair, always. I don't know if that was in the last video that I made, but I do have a beanbag chair for those who want to lounge. So I have lots of seating. Over here, it's just a stand. This is my music side of the room. This is where I got my headphones. These are Vmoda headphones. Very, very good headphones. In my opinion, better than Beats. But, I mean, Beats are great too. So you can get these, you can get Beats. These are much, much, much cheaper than Beats. Once again, they're called Vmoda. These are Vmoda LPs. There's different types of Vmodas, but can't go wrong with these. This, like I said, this is my music side, all my choir achievements. I am a singer, as you guys know. I'm not just a gamer or a sound head. I like music. I like to sing. This is my recording from high school I did. Just a whole bunch of miscellaneous things from choir, from being a music major, and all the other stuff, you know? Over here, got the mini fridge. Nothing's in it. I'm broke. Got the snack jar. There's some things in it, but you know. This is a Ninja Assassin. I'm going to play you guys a demo of the home theater for you guys, because I know that when I watch home theater videos, I like to hear it, even though you don't get a good interpretation of what the sound sounds like. I'm still going to play it, because everybody wants to hear what you're doing. So that's the video that I'm going to use, Ninja Assassin on Blu-ray. It's pretty action-packed. I don't necessarily like it, but it's pretty good. It's action-packed. So over here is my basketball achievements. This is just all the trophies that I've earned as a young child, whatever. Got a little cup. Just some couple things that it reminds me of, you know, what I used to do when I was younger and how I've grown up and how I've changed everything. So, still have my TV, still have the 42-inch Vizio. Very nice TV, does everything I needed to do. And nothing more, nothing less. It's very, very good. Very, 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 very good. So, it's 42 inches of perfection. It's not too big, not too small. Does well gaming. Vizio does well gaming. If you guys need a gaming TV, this doesn't have any input lag or anything like that. So, this is very, very nice. I don't think there's anything else new. My Xbox is the Day 1 edition. Now, those who want to know the difference between Day 1 edition and we haven't already heard, there's nothing different at all. It's just a different box and a different controller name. It's still the same controller. It just says Day 1 2013 in the middle. It's kind of stupid because it's not 2013 anymore, so your controller just looks old for no reason. I think they should just put Day 1, but it's too late. It's just my opinion, so... That's my home theater system. I am going to give you guys a demo of both music and movies on the home theater. Let me go close the blinds. Oh, I forgot one slight addition. On the floor here, you guys cannot see it, or maybe you can. When it's nice and dark and we're watching a movie, I have lights. Let me plug them in. I have lights that go around the room. Look really weird right now because it's daylight, but it gives the room a nice glow when you're watching a movie and everything. And it just loops around the entire room and goes across the sides of the room and beneath the bed and everything. It looks really, really nice, kind of like the aisles in a movie theater. It has that type of feel. So I have those two on a timer. Let's go ahead and watch an action scene from Blu-ray video.
Come, little brother. Let us play like old times. She made when I stuck her.
Gonna stop right there. That is Ninja Assassin for those who might want to get it. It's very, very gory. Hope you guys like blood and chains and other weird ninja stuff. So That's my home theater update 2014. Hope you guys like it. I think I'm going to have one more addition to the family. I'm going to get me another subwoofer from Definitive Technology. And that might be the end of my home theater setup for a little bit. So hope you guys have a great day, great week, great year. And I will see you guys on the next video. Kpaceguy out.